And some, a lot of times it's on their own. They've heard about it and they've gone to the website and joined and are reaching out to their coworkers. So while there's nothing currently planned in Austin, that could change tomorrow if a group of workers calls up and say, hey, we put a committee together at our store and this is what we want to do. So and we do have members in Austin, but nothing that's really gained momentum yet.
So you do have them. And Houston also?
Yes, Houston as well.
Can you guys comment on Walmart and the issue of fair trade?
I mean, so we all know, I mean, Walmart's one of the biggest, if not the biggest, importer of goods. So, I mean, they're looking for just complete, like, I mean, and they want no regulations. They want to be able to buy whatever they want at the cheapest price they can and dump whatever they want to dump. So, I mean, yeah, they're a huge, huge player and probably have the most to... the most to win or lose as far as importers go from the details of trade bills. And they've also, I mean, right, they've got the clout to get all the special favors in the, right, when they're negotiating this bill, you know, Walmart's people are going to be there getting this little piece of the bill that has nothing to do with anybody in the world except Walmart, and except that it'll have negative impact for workers.
This is a good time. George, go ahead.
Okay, one of the things I wanted to ask, Kevin, when you said fair trade, I lived in another country for a couple of years, New Zealand, and we had in the stores fair trade coffee, fair trade this. Is this the fair trade you're talking about? They basically helped the farmer, helped the worker, and wasn't a big conglomerate type of operation. So it usually cost a little bit more, but you knew you felt you were helping somebody else. Is that what we're talking about?
I mean, so our primary focus, right, has been on organizing workers here in the United States. So I've had very little to do with issues around what they're stocking in the stores and what they're selling. I mean, our issue, right, is about fair trade, but it's about treating workers fairly here.
We're speaking the same thing. No. Yeah. I thought. Very good. You've answered it. Thanks.
Committed for respect at Walmart.
Okay, so you focus on the word respect.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, because when it comes down to it, and I mean, we've all heard lots of it, but I mean, people work for low wages. They routinely get their hours cut with no explanation. I mean, we have people that will go from 35 hours every week that all of a sudden they only get 12 hours.
Or they get their shifts changed.
Are most of the workers female, or is it female?
Yeah, it's a majority female.
What's the word family?
Do you find a lot of your people that are in your organization that are with Walmart now, is Walmart fighting them pretty good?
So they are putting up a fight.
Intimidation.
So they are intimidating them. They're not doing it to the levels that they've done in the past, and I think it's because we fought for and won some of this space. And I really do believe that Dutch pension fund pulling their money has a big part to do with that, because Walmart's seen that there is a price to pay for treating workers badly and for the type of anti-union campaigns they've run in the past. And in addition, I mean, as we start to build momentum in the stores, they can't, and you know, they don't want to, right? They don't want to fire the good worker who is also involved in this association. Because I mean, we've got people. There's a lot of long-term Walmart employees that have gotten involved in this. I mean, people with 15, 20 years in at the company, and you know, Walmart needs those folks to make the store run. They know that, so they are fighting. They're intimidating people. But it's not to the levels we've seen in the past. Now, that could change very quickly, I think, as we increase activity. I think they're going to step up. And right, so that's part of the reason we need the kind of community support out there to let them know. I mean, there's definitely going to be a day where we're going to call on all of you and all of your networks to go to Walmart managers and tell them, look, you got to stop this intimidating activity. because it's gonna happen. And